Abigail Kubeke and Dorothy Masuka with us to continue this conversation. We were talking about leaving South Africa, and we have Tandi telling us our story, how she stayed. We've got Abigail also, we'll hear from you, and also staying through all of this. Dorothy, you had to leave though.
I had to. I'd written a song called Dr. Malano Namtoto Nzima, you know? And I'd written things like Kaoleza, I've written things like the Lumumba things, you know, songs like that. And for me, I always questioned, because being born in a country like Rhodesia then, the Brits had a little bit different laws than we had in South Africa then. South Africa was very hard. Mm. You are black, you have to stay black. And you know, like sometimes I remember very well that when I used to walk in Pretoria in my high heels, because at the time, I mean, I was one of those had to dress to kill yes. women, you know, with the high heels that you girls are wearing these days. And in Pretoria, you wouldn't go ka, ka, ka with your shoe on the pavement. The white guy would, or white woman would say, J-ras murai skune fanjo. You know, that kind of a thing.
Yeah.
And for me, I wanted to know why I couldn't go in a restaurant and drink a cup of tea sitting down, you know, because everything was so abnormal for me. So somehow I had to leave the country because they were now opening their ears and eyes and say, what say the claim Kaffernate?
Yeah.
You know, not even claim. What say?
Yeah.
Say Malan what? What it Malan Hamak? And then our old Zulu brothers in the studios would say, Mebas, say Malan esni ahuye vasni. Then they, you know, they didn't like that because there's no message sender fast or faster than a song. You can reach America in 2 seconds, you know, yeah. in a song.
Like the likes of Mary McKeever. Mm.
That's right, you know. Mm. So they knew this and they didn't like that about me.
Yeah.
Then when I went back to Rhodesia, because the same... if I may call them the names that we used for them those days, the same Boer who was here was the same Boer in Rhodesia.
Yeah.
So when I got to Rhodesia, when I heard about Lumumba, and I wanted to know how can they say Lumumba has disappeared and they don't know where he is, it didn't make sense to me. They were still after me, and I was moved. Because ANC was all over, you know, this region. South Africa, Zimbabwe, Northern Rhodesia, and Malawi. So ANC was all over the place.
Yeah.
And they had to move me until I was out of the country completely into the Londons and all that jazz.
Where you were safe and you could create your music. Abigail, different story for you. Did you not want to delve into the political side of things?
Honey, I was a politician musically.
Yeah.
My politics were in my music. I communicated with the people with my music. Some of the people did it verbally, like, you know, the Winnie Mandelas, the Ellen Kuzwayos, Tatu Mandela, and all those people. But with Miriam, our message was in our music. A lot of people were surprised when Miriam went to address United Nations. Mm. Some of them said, but Miriam is not a politician. Because they thought to be a politician, you have to stand up and say, yeah, you know, yes, we're going to kill, and whatever. And yet, we were doing it with our music. It was in our music.
Mm.
We all felt the pain, and we all dealt with it differently, in different ways. Leta Mbulu was in the States, and she sang, Chigijela ngamache, you know, throw stones. And after that, there was the 1976 uprising of the kids, and they were throwing stones, you know. So it was that. To insist and to be performing when they were saying, you are not going to perform there, and we went and performed there, it was fighting the system, you know. We wanted to prove to them that, look, you are not going to stop my life. You can stop anything else but not my life, because singing is our life, you know. So we continued, we fought and did whatever we could do the way we could do it.
It's amazing. You know, I listen to these stories, Thandi, that you ladies are telling me, and I don't want to end this interview because I want to just carry on the whole day listening to what you have to say. But you look at the privileged artists today, and I call them privileged. I'm talking about the ladies in particular.
Yes, yes.
And I mean, it's incredible to see the platform that they've got and how they're flourishing. The artists of today.
Mm-hmm.
Would you agree? I mean, are they embracing it? Is it good?
Yeah,
things are good.
They're embracing it, you know, and because some of them they've never went through what we have went through.
Yeah,
as the three of us were talking to you, you know, they are getting things.
Yeah,
you know, and Tina, we never used to go backyard in the before you go to the stage, through the kitchen, you're wearing your beautiful dress and you look scrupulous, you look good.
Yeah.
But you go through the kitchen before you go on stage because the boss and the missus are sitting there watching the native girl singing.
Yeah.
And you knew, but when you look at them, you say in yourself, I'm going to show you a higher voice.
Yeah.
Of what I can do.
That's the one thing we knew, that we never spoke about it, but you could see when one goes on stage, you come creating Mrs. Hansel Slana. She says, Slana, Hane, Jahan Mukini, Mukina.
Just to add on to what Thandi has just said,
yeah.
You know, we are very proud and happy for these youngsters.
Yes.
What they are achieving today and what they are doing today. The music has moved on. It's different from ours.
Absolutely.
It's beautiful. Life has to go on.
Mm.
But, you know, but one thing that still saddens us is that we were being discriminated by the Afrikaners, the apartheid, then.
Yeah.
And now we're being discriminated by our own people.
Yes.
Yeah.
We normally don't get work because they'll say they are old. They can't do this, they can't do that. That is the only thing that is saddening us.
Ladies.
Sorry to add what she's saying. I'm working with Afrikaners.
Yeah.
I'm doing a lot of work with Afrikaners. Yeah. And I'm even singing Afrikaner songs. Jekendai song, Advance that Jane the word Sue Fistan.
Yes, yes.
Jeken.
Yeah.
No Advert with Afrikaners.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Which is wonderful. May men say, hear my knee, that
knee.
Yes.
You're never too old to sing.
You're never too old to sing.
Oh,
ladies, I have to wrap this. I don't want to. I'm being shot. I'm going deaf in my right ear because that was shouting at me.
What
this has
gets
been amazing.
Old, it's a cloth.
Yes.
The cloth gets old, not the ladies. The Standard Bank Joy of Jazz this weekend are paying tribute and honoring these ladies, these national icons of our country. And I think if you're a musician in this country and you're listening to this, please understand how grateful you should feel to these ladies. Thank you for being our guests here on Morning Live. Happy Women's Day. And I really mean that because you deserve this wish more than anybody else I know. Dorothy Masuku, Abigail Kubeka, and Thandi Claassen. Let's take a very quick